doors open?
Oh, yeah. All right. My name's Police Constable Henry Thatcher, and this is a raid.
You are Sandy Kemp, the actor?
Yes.
I must warn you, sir, that outside I have police dog Josephine, who is not only armed and trained to sniff out certain substances, but is also a junkie.
For how long are we to put up with these things? Yours sincerely, E.B. Debenham, Mrs.
Roaming the streets, raping, looting and killing. Yours, etc., Brigadier Arthur Gormanstrop, Mrs.
Anything, or you're just going to show me films all evening?
Just one more, dear.
Oh.
Wow, Charles, at last! One of the world's most perfectly developed body!
There is one composer whose name is never included with the greats. Why is it the world never remembered the name of Johann Gamble Putty, Devon, Ausfern, Splendenschlitt, Krasskrenbon, Friediger Dangle Dungle Bar, Steinbon, Neckthresher, Applebanger, Horowitz, Tickelensick, Grandinotti Speltickel, Grandlich, Grunwaldner Speltewasser, Kürzlich, Imbel, Eisenbahnwagen, Guten Abendbitter, Einen Nürnberger Bratwürstel, Gespört mit zwei Marker Lube Hunsfoot, Gumberaber Schonendanke Kalbsfleisch, Mittelracher von Hartkopf of Ulm. We start with an interview with his only surviving relative, Karl Gamble Putty.
First met Johann Gamble Putty, Devon Ausfern, Splendenschlitt, Krasskrenbon, Friediger Dingle Dongle Dangle Doom.
All right, look, no time to lose. Ken, shave all your hair off, get your passport, and meet me at this address in Rio de Janeiro. Ken, we start to have plastic surgery, meet me there. Reg, go to Canada, work your way south to Nicaragua by July. Larry, you stay here as frontman. Give us 15 minutes, then blow the building up. All right, make it fast!
Hey, boss, you can't blow the building up.
Why not?
It's illegal.
Oh, bloody hell.
Mr. Milton, you are sole proprietor and owner of the Wizzo Chocolate Company.
I am.
Superintendent Parrott and I are from the hygiene squad.
Would you read that, Edgar?
What's that, dear?
There's been another Indian massacre at Dorking Civic Theatre.
Oh, a Scotsman on a horse.
For Mrs. Emma Hamilton of Nelson, a Scotsman on a horse.
A police, Prissy. We know you're in there, sir. Come out with your hands up high and there'll be no trouble.
You'll never take me alive, copper.
Oh, all right.
All right, boys.
Mr. Salisbury.
Sit down.
We're going to take a hard, tough, abrasive look at camel spotting.
Hello.
Hello, Peter.
Mr. Salisbury, aren't you in fact a train spotter?
What?
Don't you in fact spot trains?
Oh, you're no fun anymore.
Capital investment of £10 million. This firm last year made a complete profit of a shilling.
A shilling, Wilkins?
Roughly, yes, sir.
It was a day like many another, and Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Brainsample were a perfectly ordinary couple leading perfectly ordinary lives. The sort of people to whom nothing extraordinary ever happens. And not the kind of people to be the center of one of the most astounding incidents in the history of mankind. So let's forget about them and follow instead the destiny of this man. Harold Potter, gardener and tax official, first victim of creatures from another planet.
Mrs. Potter, you knew Mr. Potter quite well, I believe.
Oh, yes, quite well. He was my husband.
Yeah.
Help me. Please help me.
But what can I do?
Surely, Charles, you're the chief scientist at the Anthropological Research Institute. A bucky down. An expert in what makes people change from one nationality to another.
So I am. This is right up my street.
Oh, good.
Mr. Angus Podgorny, owner of a Dunbar menswear shop, received an order for 48 million kilts from the planet Skyron in the galaxy of Andromeda.
Ugh, you're a stupid man, Angus Podgorny.
Oh, Mary. We'll be rich. We'll be rich.
Oh. Wilkins, are you a pacifist?
No, sir, I'm not a pacifist, sir. I'm a coward.
Two civilian gentlemen to see you, sir.
Show them in, please, Sergeant.
Mr. Dino Vercottis and Mr. Luigi Vercottis.
All frontal nudity, never. What do you think, Barbara?
Oh, no, no. There's a perfect balance, of course.
Base of the new ordinar. Hello there, Father, Confessor, Professor, Your Honour, Your Grace.
I'm not Your Grace. I'm Your Elsie.
What a terrible joke!
But it's my only line!
I'll get someone to attend to you. Mr. Verrett here.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes. The length is, Lambert?
Hmm?
What is the length of the comfy down, Majorette?
2 foot long. Morning, Frank.
Morning, Norman.
Morning, Frank.
Morning, Lionel.
Frank!
Yes, Han?
Can I borrow your goat?
Hello, Polly! Polly! Polly Perrot, wake up! Polly!
And now for something completely different. The office of Sir George Head. O-B-E.
Next, please.
Now, what are your names?
Arthur Wilson.
Arthur Wilson, right. Well, look, I'll call you Arthur Wilson 1 and you Arthur Wilson 2, just to avoid confusion. Jimmy's put his heads together and worked out a way up. Jimmy? Ah, oh, I don't believe you've met. Jimmy Blenkinsop, Arthur Wilson, Arthur Wilson, Jimmy Blenkinsop. Hello. Arthur Wilson 2, Jimmy Blenkinsop 1. Jimmy Blenkinsop, Wilm, Arthur Wilson, too. Carry on, Jimmy's.
Vercottis Turners, for only attention.
Louise, I told you never to call me at the office.
Oh, Bevis! And I thought you were so rugged!
Many of my best friends are lumberjacks, and only a few of them are transvestites. Yours faithfully, Brigadier Sir Charles Arthur Strong, Mrs.
Whoa! I think television's killed real entertainment.
My name is Kenny Lush, and I'm your compere for tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we give you Ken Budda and his inflatable knees. Ken Budda, a smile, 2 bangs, and a religion. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for your fair entertainment, Brian Islam and Brucey.
Oh, Iris, you're so very beautiful.
Oh, Victor.
Silly, isn't it?
Oh.
Awkward this evening.
I'm Arthur. Arthur name. Name by name, but not by nature. I always say that, don't I, Vicky boy?
Really?
Hello.
Good evening. What are you doing?
My name is Equator. Brian Equator. Light round the middle of the earth, only with an L.
This is my wife, Audrey. She smells a bit, but she has a heart of gold.
Got a television part. You missed him.
And a special good evening to you. Not just an ordinary good evening like you get from all the other announcers, but a special good evening from me to you. But now it's the glittering world of show business with Arthur Tree.
Hello, hello, people, and welcome to It's a Tree. And an unusual guest for this programme, a piece of laminated plastic.
Hi there.
But first, will you please, please welcome a block of wood. Well, Block, nice to have you on the show again.
Well, thanks, Tree.
I've got to stop you there, Block, I'm afraid, because we've got someone who's been doing cabaret in the New Forest from America. Will you welcome, please, a Chippendale writing desk?
Thank you, Mr. Tree.
Ah, Mr. Anchovy. Do sit down.
Thank you.
And today, another Englishman may add his name to the golden roll of history. Mr. Ron Obvious of Neep's End.
Behind Ron's cross-channel jump is his manager, Mr. Luigi Vercottis. Mr. Vercottis.
Vercottis.
What?
Vercottis.
How long would that take?
Oh, let me see. Stripping the fur off, no legs. Harry!
Yeah?
Can you do a parrot job on this, can you do a parrot job on this terrier straight away?
No, I'm still putting a tuck in the Airedale, and then I've got the frogs to let out.
Mr. Phipps. Kong. You can be our next librarian. You're proud, majestic, and fierce enough. Will you do it?
I don't think I can, sir.
Ah, Mr. Pattinson. Sit.